On the standard 21-chord button, Autoharp, we won't have all the chord buttons for all the harmonies that are available in the 84 harmony, all keys Autoharp chord bar configuration. So for example, one wouldn't find the chord buttons for C sharp major or B flat minor or the diminished thirds, augmented thirds, dominant sevenths, sixths or minor sevenths for those keys on a standard set of buttons for a 21-chord bar Autoharp. So in this video, I'd like to explain how one can go about using the existing chord buttons that we have on the normal 21-chord button Autoharp in order to represent those 84 different harmonies. As well as that, in the latter part of this video, I'd like to provide a new table showing the complete schematic for all the positive and negative notch patterns on the 21 different chord bars in this 84 harmony, all keyed Autoharp chord bar arrangement. So to begin with, as regards this current slide, the photograph at the top shows the normal 21 chord buttons arrangements that are found on the standard 21 chord button Autoharp. So in the top row, we have the seventh chords, and they are arranged generally in the order of ascending fifths. So we have the F major seventh, followed by the C major seventh, followed by the G major seventh. And then in the middle row, we have similarly arranged in ascending fifths, the major chords. So we have B flat major, F major, C major, and G major. And then in the bottom row, we have the relative minor chords arranged similarly in ascending fifths. So we have G minor, D minor, and A minor, and so forth. So as regards the photograph in the lower half of the slide, as you might recall from the previous video, we have this first block there of the 12 major, minor, sevenths, and sixth chord buttons, and so they are arranged in ascending fourths. So we have C sharp major, F sharp major, B, E, A, D, G, C, F, B flat, E flat, and A flat. So what I've done here is that I've made use, as best I could, of the buttons that are available. So we do have the buttons for G major, C major, F major, B flat, E flat, A flat, A, and B major. Because we don't have the buttons for C sharp, F sharp, B, and E major, I'm using the seventh buttons for C seventh, F seventh, B seventh, and E seventh, respectively. And if you might recall from the previous video, in order to play the minor chords, we need to press the same button as its relative major. So for example, for the key of B flat minor, we need to press the same button as the major chord for its relative major, which is C sharp major. So the C seventh button there is the button for C sharp major, so that acts as the same button for B flat minor. Similarly, for the minor chord of A minor, we have to press the chord buttons for its relative major key, which is C major. So as regards the A minor, we need to press C major in order to sound the A minor chord. So using these standard buttons on a 21 chord Autoharp, we can't indicate both major and minor keys on the same button. So we just have to go by a rule of thumb that when we press a major chord, that same button is used to sound its relative minor chord as well. And moving on to these four buttons here, which are the four positive augmented third buttons. The reason why they are called augmented third is because when we play any three of those in combination, then it sounds an augmented third chord. The reason why they're called positive, because notes arranged in intervals of thirds are cut out as positives on the dampening felt. And in order to produce the major, minor, major seventh, and major sixth chords, we need to press these buttons plus one from these 12 here. And as you might recall from the previous video, these four buttons are numbered, starting with number one. This is the position of number one, and this is number two, this is number three, and this is number four. And the reason why they're numbered in such a way is because that keeps the same numbering pattern that was used in the original all keys chord button configuration, as shown in the first video. So as you can tell, as regards those buttons, they are arranged upside down. The reason for that is that we wish to distinguish these four buttons from the letters that represent the 12 buttons. And as well as that, when inverted upside down, they don't exactly represent the numerals 1, 2, 3, and 4, but they are similar enough to remind us of where these numbers are. So for example, the inverted E here reminds us of the number 3. And so we know that the next one alongside it is number 4, and below that is number 1. And this one here, the inverted G, reminds us slightly of 2 as well. So here we have the blank slot, which acts as the ring finger holder, which allows us to play the chord buttons with the correct fingering and in the correct position. And as regards this button, I have chosen to use the D7th button because this is the dampener button, so the D here stands for dampener. As regards these last column of buttons here, as you might remember from the previous video, they are the diminished third chords. So in this configuration, I have actually changed the positions of the chord bars for these last three chord bars so that they are in keeping with the notes of the chord buttons that are on the same row. So for example, this button here, which is the chord button for the diminished third of G minor, B flat minor, C sharp minor, and E minor, they are in keeping to the chord buttons to the left, which are the chord buttons of C sharp, E, G, and B flat. Similarly, this chord button here, which is the chord button for C minor, E flat minor, F sharp minor, and A minor, they are in keeping with these buttons here to the left on the same row, which are the buttons for F sharp, A, C, and E flat. Similarly, for this button here, which is the button for D minor, F minor, A flat minor, and B minor, they are in keeping with the buttons to the left, which are the buttons for B, D, F, and A flat. So if you are doing the conversion to this 84 harmony, all keys autoharp configuration, then I would recommend, then because we don't have the correct buttons for all the 84 different harmonies, I would recommend using this configuration of buttons from the normal 21 sets of chord buttons to help us identify which button represents which chord. So here we have a new table showing the schematic of the positive and negative felt patterns for the 21 different chord bars in the 84 harmony all keys autoharp chord bar configuration, and they are arranged in the very latest 12-4-3-RD chord button order. So if you're doing the conversion, I would recommend that you watch videos 2, 3, and 14 for walkthroughs on how to do the conversion. But as regards the ordering of which chord bars should go into which slot, I would recommend that you use this schematic because this is the most up-to-date. So that is all for this video. Just a brief explanation of which chord buttons to use for the 12-4-3-RD 84 harmony all keys autoharp chord bar configuration from the 21 chord buttons available on a standard 21 button autoharp. And as well as that, this new, more up-to-date table showing the positive and negative felt patterns on the 21 different chord bars. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do have any comments, feedback, or suggestions, then do leave them down below. Otherwise, in the meantime, until next time, have a nice day.